In this video, we will talk about how to autosave your case and data files after every few iterations. This can be a very useful feature to prevent huge amounts of time and data loss due to unexpected crashes or machine failure. You can access the autosave panel from either File, Write, Autosave, or you can go to the Solving tab and click on Autosave under Activities. In the autosave panel, you can choose how often you want to save your data file. You can enter the number of iterations, for example 10, then the data files will be saved every 10 iterations. Now along with the data files, you may want to save the case files as well. This is especially important when the case files also get modified with the number of iterations or with time for a transient problem. You can choose to save your case files only if the case file is modified, for example for a sliding mesh problem, or you can choose to save the case files each time the data file is saved. Now the second important option is called the file storage options. Here we can enable whether we want to retain only the most recent files, and if so, how many number of data files from the previous saves do we want to retain. If this option is turned off, then only the previously saved data file and the case file are retained, and they are overwritten every time a new set of data files and case file need to be saved. So if you turn this option on, we can specify whether we want to save the previous 5 files or the previous 10 files. But remember, the more number of data files and case files we save, the more storage is consumed. So in this case, just for trial, let's say we want to save data file every 1 iteration, which is something that you would not want to do in real life because that's saving it too frequently. But just for trial purposes, let's set it to 1, and let's say we want to save a maximum number of data files of 5. That means the previous 5 data files should be retained. Click on OK. And let's run this calculation for 10 iterations. Now that the calculation is complete, let's take a look at the number of data files that are saved. So you can see in this folder we have several case and data files. And as requested, only the 5 previous sets of case and data files are retained. You can see that all these case and data files have the prefix of the number of iterations, and that helps us identify which iteration number this case and data file pertain to.